Dr. Ripple wrote a letter to the Sentinel, our local paper in Lawns, decrying the fact that people were dying from addiction.
He had a family history with losing someone. He was very involved in wanting this not to happen to another family.
The genesis for the Ripple Recovery House started back in 2015-2016 when we started having conversations with a resident of that community, Nikki Collins. Nikki has been very involved in the recovery community for many years, and she expressed her concerns and shared a bit of her story about her role in the recovery community and the help that she was providing other people. Dr. Ripple, through conversation with him, we had expressed interest or the need to try to get more community involvement, and he was able to bring together a group of concerned citizens, which later formed as the DART group.
Then they just kind of kept meeting and trying to figure out ways to form some kind of a facility to help drug addicted people in their recoveries.
When we asked Great Lakes, they were everywhere in the UP, and we wondered why they weren't here. And they said, well, no one ever invited us, so.
The DART team locally, they invited us in, and we were just happy to get the call from them and start partnering.
Great Lakes Recovery came forward with a plan to put a recovery home in that community for female residents coming out of post-treatment. And the Superior Health Foundation supplied a fairly substantial amount of money. Dr. Ripple and some others contributed, and we ended up coming in with an additional source of funds to help get that program up and running and the house open.
We were originally trying to get a detox center here, but it was too involved with the licensing and the counselors. And we were looking for different locations. We looked up at the Hilltop, up at D'Agostino, and this house was for sale.
The reason this developed, right, is a lot of times we found that people would leave residential treatment and they didn't have a safe place to go. Maybe they didn't have any place to go. And so this idea of recovery houses where people can have sort of a more long-term supportive housing that's really conducive to their recovery is really what we're doing here. And so that's what we're hoping to do in the Lawns community.
Well, it helps them integrate back into society. They will get a job and then they'll pay rent. 30% of their gross will come out of their check. And they have a year, roughly, to live, sometimes a little bit longer if needed. Just do the basic needs that they need to do to get back on their feet.
Personally, if I had a place like this when I was in treatment afterwards, I would not have to go to treatment twice. So this is their home. And so they decide when they leave. And also, children will be allowed to live here. Imagine your child growing up in a sober environment, having a sober mom, having sober aunts all over the place. And that's really important.
It's an amazing effort to be able to have homes for folks that are early in the recovery process. So it's part of our mission. We know that a key to enhanced recovery and long-term recovery support starts with a good foundation. And so those folks coming out of primary treatment or tertiary care need to have a wonderful place to stay as they take the other steps in their life. And in this Lawns home, the Ripple Recovery Residence, is really an achievement of the community coming together to be able to help us provide that for, in this particular case, women in their recovery journey.
This project wouldn't happen without the community. We don't have an office in Lawns. We don't have an office in Baraga County even. And so, had there not been this much support, this would have never happened.
We needed to paint these rooms. These rooms were painted by volunteers who had nothing to do with us whatsoever, but just said, hey, the National Honor Society at Lawns High School came over. Their teacher came over with them and spent a day painting. This is a community effort.
That community had a group of people that were invested to find a solution, and they stuck with it. They wouldn't let it go. And thank God that they didn't, because you know, now there's this resource that exists in this community to help this community. And again, it's one step, and it's another piece of that puzzle that we can start building and adding on to.
Not all communities are quite as open and resourceful as the group here in Lotz and in Berga County. So it is really something to be cherished.
This is a real role model, an example of how that persistence and that tenacity to continue to advocate for your community sooner or later will find a scalable solution.